السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله إخواني في الله يا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وقوله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون صدق الله العظيم يا عباد الله إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإعوذ بالله يا إخواني في الله بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى today سنتناول we're going to talk about the hadith من حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الحمد لله we can find the hadith in Ibn Majah وهذا حديث قد حسنة الشيخ الألباني في التحقيق في التحقيق من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنه قال عنهما قال أقبل علينا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا محشر المؤجرين the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم رسول الله he turned This is hadith narrated by Umar, Ibn Umar, radiallahu anhumah. He said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, he turned to us, and then he said, Ya ma'ashar al-muhajirin, O muhajirin, O the migrate. He said, O noble men of muhajirin, come soon, idha tulitum bihinna, wa'auzu billahi am turhikuhunna. He says, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, come soon, five bad things will happen that all of us, we're gonna befall on that five things we're gonna be happening. He said, His Ummah, my Ummah, in the end of the time. He said, Wa'uzu billah, he seek refuge from Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. That's not gonna happen in your time. But today, it happened on our time. We see every detail from our eyes. And then we are inside. And then we ourselves in that calamity from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ibadallah, the first one, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَمْ تَزْحَرُ الْفَاهِشَ فِي قَوْمِ قَتُ حَتَّى يُؤْلِنُ بِهَا إِلَّا فَشَى فِيهِمْ أَصَّعُونَ وَعَوْجَاسِ الَّتِي لَمْ تَكُنْ أَمَدَّتْ فِي أَسْلَافِهِمْ لَذِي مَدَى. He says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the first of the five, the sexual obscenity will become a wide and spread opening from top every one of us. It will become a normal, a zina. It will become a normal from top all of us. And then he said, he talking to his ummah, and then he said, and it will never happen except if they start on that time, they will commit all those things, that sexuality, zina, that time they will publicize, they will open. No one gonna hide. And then the ummah will commit all those things, and then he will come out and he will open him. He will say what he does last night or yesterday or last time. And then the Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that mean they will be proud about it. And then they will be proud to talking about it. They will feeling good to talk about what they did. They don't have to do it. They will do it, and then they will be proud to talk about it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they make i'lan, yani mean for it, they will make adversity, they will make it, they will show up, they will open in front of everyone, and then the zina will be opening. Allah cover you. You did your haram, your masiyah, and in the next day you will come out and shout, oh, I did this last night, I did this yesterday, I did this. The Prophet said, in the other hadith, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this kind of a people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never forgive them what they're doing, and they will pay for it. Ya ibadallah, wafasha zina, the zina will spread. And then he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if this happening, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it will spread. And then he said, what when that time coming, what's gonna happen? The illness, the disaster, the pain, and the never existing before, it will come to us. The illness, the disease will come to us. That means something will come to us or our ancestor before them. Something will come. The disease, the illness, the sickness. We will ask ourselves where this it come from, and then it will spread everywhere. Today we see. Ataun mean. Those days, that time Ta'un mean, they know of sickness, they know of sickness, that it will throw off the dead. Nobody don't know where it come from. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said this hadith 1,400 years ago, but it happened today. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُّ يُوحَىٰ. He never say anything from his mind or from his desire. All is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said this, but it happened today in front of all of us. We see it. We are inside. We see today, we have HIV, we have AIDS, we have STD, sexually transmitting disaster, we don't know where it comes from. Everyone is sick. Every country we see today, the desire, the The disaster is happening. Why? Because what Allah and His Messenger say to us will leave us. We follow our own desire. وَيَّازُ بِاللَّهِ أَكُولِ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ لِزَمْلِ فَإِنَّهُ وَقَفُرُ اللَّهِ.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد.
The fight of the team, the first, the sexuality will be spread on the ear. The second, ولم ينقط المقيال والميزان. المقيال والميزان. The Muslim will cheat on their business. Today, what happened? We cheating on our business and tried as a livelihood. You know, we cheating become our business livelihood. We live on it. You know, they live on the cheating, the lying, and the betraying each other. That's what happened today. I know this, my brother, he have right on me because I got power, the power of God. I'm going to take him away because I have power and I'm going to get that right. But you don't know that. Allah said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if this time come to us, he said, illa ukhizu bi sinin wa shidda wa ma'unnat wa jawri sultanin alayhim. He said, if that happen, they will streak. That means the poverty will spread in the air. And then the dictating ruler and oppressive ruler upon them. That means what? You know, mashallah, subhanallah, this hadith is very beautiful because it's a lesson for us to reflect back. That means the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if this thing happened, we killing our business, we do whatever we want. He said, you know, every country today in the world, everyone is complaining about their governments. Because the Prophet said, Allah will bring someone to us who gonna bring a dictating. He will bring a dictating ruler to us. He will rule us on his own desire. Because we are out what Allah has told us. We do what we want today. That's why Allah bring this calamity to us. And then the third, وَلَمْ يَمْنَعُ زَكَاتَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ الزَّكَاتِ. You know, how many Muslims today, you know, we stop paying zakat. I can say how many Muslims even know the rule of zakat? How many of Muslims know today? We don't know even the rule of zakat. There's no excuse for us. We don't have no rule. We don't know the rule of the zakat. But if the time comes when we stop and pay zakat, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ila muni ul qatra min as-samai wa lawl al-baha'im lam yamtaru. He says sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if that time comes, Allah will stop the sky from rain. But we get rain from where? From who? Because of the daba, of the animal. The animal. If it's not the other's animal and it is nature, Allah will stop his rain. We never get rain from the sky. And in the fourth, he said, وَلَمْ يَنْقُتُوا أَحْدَ اللَّهِ وَحْدَ الرَّسُولِ صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, Muslims will betray their promise and the loyalty to Allah and his messenger. Look at today. We have no loyalty. We break the promise. We break the promise between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. We break it. Illa salatullah alayhim aduwan min khayrihim fa'akhazuhu ba'du ma fi aydihim. Why? If that time come, we break the promise. Allah said, he will bring someone to us. Those people, they will come and then they will take what we have in our hand. What we have in our hand. You know, today, look at the Muslim country today. There's someone come who is not Muslim, a non-Muslim, they will rule us. They will take what from us. And they will take care of our own thing, our own money, our own land, our own family. They, because we become followers. So and then the last five, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا لَكُمْ تَحْكُمُ عَئِمَّتُكُمْ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ وَيَتَغَيَّرُ مِمَّا أَنزَلُ اللَّهِ. He said, Muslim leader will not apply. You know, if we go to the Muslim country today, we not apply no more Muslim rule. We apply our own desire. Allah, the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if that time come, how come you can rule? You know, you can rule the land, the ear, the world of someone. What is not your own? Or you are Muslim. Allah give us Al Quran and the Hadith to rule our own country, our own land, our own, because we live that we took our own desire. The Prophet says sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if that time come the country we manage illa ja'alallahu ba'sahum baynahum. He said, they unite, we will be disunited. We will be disunited. Because we took our own desire to rule our country. We are Muslim. Allah give us Quran and Hadith. He give us everything, every muscle in the Quran, how to rule, how to take care of our wife, how to take care of our children, how to take care of our family, how to take care of our job, our business. But we leave that, we say, let me take my own desire. Let me take what I read in my school. Well, let me take what I want. Let me take what the Western country tell us to do. That's what Allah said, He will bring disunity. We'll be disunited. Look at us today. Look at a Muslim country today. We are disunited. How come? كيف تدرون الدنيا بدون خالق الدنيا؟ كيف تدرون الدنيا بغير خالق الدنيا؟ How come you can rule, you can manage a world without the creator? How? إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ بِقَوْمِهِ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ بِمَا بِأَنفُسِكُمْ. Allah will never change our situation until we change our situation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us good understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us good strong iman. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ كَمَا صَلَّيْتَ عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَعَلَى آلِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَبَارِكْ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ كَمَا بَارَكْتَ عَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَعَلَى آلِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِنَّكَ حَمِيدٌ مَجِيدٌ. اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات وأياهم ومنهم أموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا, اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا, اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا وأصلح ذات بيننا, وأصلح ذات بيننا. اللهم بلغ رمضان, اللهم بلغنا رمضان, اللهم بلغنا رمضان. يا عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل وإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر وبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقيموا الصلاة.